So I had a request to go through my educational journey. So this is the third in a set of videos going right from secondary school all the way through my degree and to getting a job. And this one is how to pick a degree. And I don't necessarily recommend picking a degree in the way that I picked a degree. I picked architecture because I kind of read about it when I was looking up archaeology. It was near archaeology in the list of university courses that I was looking at in the library. And it sounded like me. It sounded like a bit of everything. It sounded like a little bit sciencey, a little bit arty, a little bit maths, a little bit written communication, a little bit everything. And I don't regret picking that degree at all. You know, really that degree was picked and it enabled me to keep these various interests alive. And I think that's actually a really important thing. If you're somebody who likes lots of different things, then just keep those interests alive. There's nothing wrong with that. And at every stage in your education journey, whenever you have those options, pick things that you think you're going to enjoy and keep those doors open and keep those interests alive. You want to get to the point where you can be an employee who is able to learn things and able to show they can work hard. And actually, the things you learn in your job don't tend to be that related to what you did in your degree anyway. Now, once you've done your A-levels, then you become quite narrow and specialised down certain routes, and you've already closed certain doors. If you don't do English A-level, then you're probably not going to go on to study English at university. You've closed doors. So you've already got a narrower list of degrees that you can pick from. So I have no regrets at all about picking the degree that I picked. I do think that I should have looked a bit more closely at the actual course that I picked. The architecture was definitely right for me, but I probably would have been better going to a more arty architecture school than the one I went to. That being said, I flipping love my university and I had a wonderful experience at Edinburgh University. I had an amazing experience at university, and honestly every university in the UK offers an amazing experience. But what I would stress to you is look closely at the actual course, because there are amazing courses for specific subjects at certain places and they are more or less suited to different people. So read in detail what that course offers, rather than thinking that every architecture course, for example, is the same, rather than thinking that every physics course is the same. Look in detail at the exact course that you're going to, not just the university you're going to. You know, honestly, I had no real idea of who I was at university, and I don't want to ham it up as a kind of voyage of discovery, because it wasn't that at all. You're going to university as a 19-year-old, I wasn't an adult. I'll be honest, I thought I was probably, but I wasn't. And I think I grew up quite slowly over those 4 years, to be honest. And it was only really when I got a job that I started to find myself as an adult. And I quickly realised that the thing that was going to lead me through the different points in life wasn't going to be that degree, but it was going to be the ability to show that I could work hard. But that being said, what my degree gave me was a vast array of transferable skills. And that's what I'll talk about in the next video. And maybe there's a chance that I should have realised earlier that I wasn't going to go into architecture as a career, and that I perhaps should have changed my degree to something else. But that being said, I still wouldn't change my degree for anything. You know, universities are good. It's not quite the same as schools in terms of the pastoral care. You know, you aren't a child at university. You are expected to ask the questions yourself rather than people ask you how you're doing. If you aren't sure about it, if you think you've picked the wrong degree once you're at a university, it's relatively easy to change courses early on or at the end of first year. So don't be shy about having those conversations with the people that are responsible for your education, your academic tutors at school. Don't be shy to say, I'm not sure I picked the right course, and see if there are better options for you. That being said, it's a totally valid option to finish one degree and start another one as postgraduate. There's loads of different options you can do. Universities are wonderful places, and if you like, you can stay there for the rest of your life.